Has everyone read the minutes?
Make a motion, make up the meeting, minutes of the March 21st meeting.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Done. Okay, discuss differences in budget recommendations. Brian, why don't you take the wheel on this one and guide us through?
All right. Start with the operations budget. So just the background, the finance committee met independently, the select board met independently and discussed. Finance committee met first to discuss budget recommendations, and the select board met and discussed those as well. And you'll see the sheet titled Finance Committee Proposed Changes Additions.
Yep.
That one. So FY18 operations budget. So what I did was I wrote down what the finance committee recommendation was, and then it's kind of a real quick summary of the select board discussion that happened around that.
Okay.
And in terms of the FY18 operations budget, there was just one issue, and that was the recommendation that the police department budget be reduced by $2,500,
mm-hmm.
with the goal of reducing the increase to approximately 5%. And the select board talked about that, and I think we just wanted to have a general discussion about why that was, I guess.
Yep.
Well, it was the overall increase in that budget as a whole.
Right.
And we could identify, and a few of us have identified different parts of that budget that we thought were high, but we didn't feel it was our place to be identifying where the cuts were to be made. But I think the original budget, and I don't have it here, probably to somewhere was 6.7%. We felt it was reasonable to ask for some reduction in that. The police budget, based on the fact that we were looking at level funding across the board, and that was one area in town that, or in the budget, overall budget, that was in excess of what we had requested. So looking for something coming back. And then mm-hmm. come up with the 5%, it was about come up with the $2,500. It really was to at least get down to 5% increase.
Yeah.
It was. Just so you understand what we were thinking, it was the one cut that was out there.
And it's the one area, one budget.
One big
budget. I get that.
So you can get it, but that's the one that's the hot, that's by far an increase that's way above what anybody else is asking for.
Well, I guess I would, and just so you know the background of the conversation that we had, there are a lot of budgets that have an increase of a higher increase than what the police ask for, but they're not big budgets. So people say, oh, it's a small amount of money, we're gonna let that go. But because the police department has a higher budget than most departments in town, it gets labeled, it gets looked at. But to just say it's a higher increase percentage-wise than a lot of other departments, it's just not,
it's not accurate. Percentages and dollars.
Well,
so I can look at it in dollars as well and say that it's an increase. And if you want to start looking at line item things, we can start looking at the line items and start looking at things that personally I think might not be necessary this year that we can cut. But I'm certainly not a police officer, and I don't think it's my area of expertise.
Well,
so.
Right. And I guess my point was, you know, Tri-Town Beach, 9.23%. Cemetery Commission, 3.28%. So it's not as if the police percentage was higher than everybody else. It just happens to be.
So it was a dollar increase.
It's a dollar.
So it's a dollar and percent increase.
But that's because they're, and then you look at highway, and.
Okay, so now you're gonna say the highway only went up 2%,
yeah.
And because their budget is so high, the dollar amount, that's obvious.
Well, but I guess that's sort of my point. We're not looking at these line items from a consistent.
We are. This is our job to take a look at them. We drill down. We could do the same thing with the school committee, but we could say, you know, if we had time to drill down to each one of their line items, we could say, is that necessary or isn't that necessary? But they're the experts. But at some point, you got to stand up, and you can't just rubber stamp
right,
everything
but
that's
but
coming
across. But, and again, correct me if I'm wrong, but the stand up was with one department.
So if you want, we'll go back and we'll start asking.
We can look at every department if you want.
Wouldn't that be practical? I mean, you're right, none of us are police experts except for the police. None of us are school experts except for the school, and on and on and on. But we picked on one department. So, because you drilled down on one department, and I'm just saying, let's be consistent with how we...
Well, that's the one that jumped out at us.
So, Brian, what page are we on here for the police budget?
Well, are you on 4 or 4A? Which one are we looking at? There's two different ones here. There's 4 without the decrease, and then 4A is within the decrease, Brian?
Correct.
So we should be looking at 4A then?
4. And what are you talking about?
The third page, it's on the kind of top.
Oh, yeah.
The two buttons. The first two pages say 4, and then there's some that say 4A.
The only difference between those two is the...
Too far.
Brian asked for a flat budget for each department.
Correct.
And he got a flat budget from, you know, not a ton.
Each department increased. Like, I was just going through some of these.
Yeah.
Like the cemetery commissioners, the bulk of that increase is in salary.
Yeah, I know.
And, you know, all these little ones that you're talking about, the increase, what, 1, 2%, a lot of it is salaries. The police department, over the years, it just keeps going up and up and up and up. It's 5, 6%, 4, 5, 6% every year. We ask for a level funding, we don't get it.
I don't know if that's 100% true, because I mean, I've been doing the budget for 14 years, and for the majority of that time, we've been level funded or... cut percentage-wise, the towns come and said, we're going to cut 1% across the board for everybody. They've never specifically targeted one department and said, we're cutting this much from you. It's been that way. It's been level funded. And the increases, talking about the salary increases, that's the vast majority of our increases from salary. So, you're talking about salary increases.
Salaries and
dollars.
Twin bill. And, you know, then you want to increase.
Quinn bill's not in our control.
No. I mean, but it's on here.
Quinn bill is an unfunded mandate. We may or may not like the Quinn bill, but there's nothing we can do about it. It's sort of like when people...
Yes, we did. We could have voted it out when we had the chance, and we didn't. Don't say we couldn't do it.
And as far as the Quinn bill, that's not even fully funded. That's just the town's half.
And I'm sorry, I don't have it in front of me, Jim. Yeah. But we've asked departments to come in, and we question their line items.
That's what we're supposed to do.
That's what we do. Yeah. And so, you know, Jim or the department head answers the questions, and okay, it's great. We don't decide at that point, but we go back, we take a look at it, and we have looked at that budget. And I will say that there are two things, without looking at it, there's two things in my eyes that I think that because there was an increase, a salary increase that was jumping that department's budget up, I think that there was a couple of, whether we feel they were absolutely necessary or a couple luxury items in there, but there was one we're asking for a third taser. With that taser, comes testing that taser, which is, you know, do we really need a third taser, okay? Do we increase uniform allowances? We've done that in the past. No, we're not where he wants to be. We have increased it in the past, but he's not where he wants to be, and I appreciate that. But we can't go taking all these things at once and just dumping it into 1 year as an increase. And I think I was the one that started the conversation saying, you know, there is a big number there as far as the percentage of an increase of 6.whatever%. And part of that was asking for a third taser. And personally, I thought that that's a luxury item for the town. I don't know how many times we've used the two that we've had, but I don't think we have at all. So a third, I think, is...
And Joe, don't get me wrong, I'm not defending his budget. What I'm saying is that we're treating his budget...
Oh, you're wrong. Because we went through, we questioned everybody that comes through.
The way we read it, in looking at those items he just talked about, in addition to things that we don't use, stuff like that, we are not supposed to go back to the department head and tell him what to cut. That's up to him. We just cut the budget total.
It's the,
and let him and this, deduct right.
You're assuming that that's the way
but
that
it's the only department that...
But this may
okay,
be...
So let's pass
this
it because that's the way it looks. That's not a fact. We went through and we look at everybody's budget.
We can say something. It seems to me if we look at the, let's look at the forest through the trees here, the taser being a tree or in a branch of a tree. Total operation budget percent change, -0.16. So that would say to me that it's pretty level funded, all else being equal.
Where are you looking at that?
We're looking at the third page.
You've got a 6.47% increase.
No, the police has increased. I get that. But the total operating budget, of which the police is a small, is a part.
On
the third page, percent change is actually, it's actually 0.16 negative. So in fact,
0.21. Okay, good.
Do you see where I am?
Yes.
Okay, percent change.
Right.
-0.16.
Right.
So I think you guys and us have done a pretty darn good job at keeping the budget level funded, it looks like. Am I wrong?
So far, it looks good.
And I think you could throw the taser back in there if it's absolutely essential. And I'm not saying it is. I'm not sure any tasers are absolutely essential. And it'd still be level funded.
And we may, it's as everyone has said, it's not our responsibility to tell the individual department heads how to run their department.
Yeah.
But at the beginning of this whole process, every department head was asked to the best of their ability to level fund their department. Okay, so here we are at the end of the game, and what stood out to us like a sore thumb was the police department, because of both dollars and percent.
Right.
Okay, so that just jumped out at us. But yeah, if you want to look at some of the other small departments, they don't have that kind of impact. And can we cut everybody every year? And the answer to that is usually no.
No, of course not.
So maybe we take a look at departments who have a spike in a given year, and that spike we try to take the top of to try to help long term the keeping the whole issue of taxation down. And we've done a good job.
We have done a good job. Veterans up 9.21%. Cemetery up 3.4%. What's 13.28 is cemetery, is that right? I'm having a hard time.
Look at cemetery, that was because of salary.
Okay, but a lot of this is.
Well, but that's it.
No.
But the majority of the
Jim has a lot of salary too. That's what I don't get.
The majority of the increase is the
salary.
Totally.
Tri-Town Beach.
Yep.
No one even knew what a gatekeeper was.
No kidding.
And I've gone there.
Deerfield runs the whole thing.
And I've gone there, and I've never had anything checked.
No.
So why do we keep that in the budget? I guess that's sort of my
that's
point.
A good question, but that's not a question for right now. No,
but it is because we didn't ask that question like we did.
We did, but we didn't know where to go get the answer.
We brought up that question.
But if people don't come to defend us, then that's at their peril.
I think what we need right now is a defense of this cutback in the police department budget. It sounds like you guys had a discussion with the police department that this was going to have a deleterious effect on their operations. So if that's the case, then he needs to come and tell us right now why this cutback to 5%, $2,500 is going to have a significant impact on your department. I think that's where it is. Not this keep apples to apples and oranges to oranges. Let's find out why the guy on the street says this is going to have an impact. So tell us.
Well, I mean, we met. I presented the budget the way it was. Again, the majority of the increase is the salary. The taser is a one-time item. That's $1,200 that'll come off next year. It's a one-time purchase for it. Discussing with the town administrator, should we do that as a capital item or should I include it in the budget? It was recommended just to put it in the budget because it was only $1,200, not $5,000. So So that's where the taser went. Some of the other increases were adding $500 because the longevity wasn't added. Somebody's mistake last year didn't get added to the budget. So there's things in the budget. So when you take out the salary increase and when you take out the one-time purchase of the taser and the other items, I'm not looking for a huge increase. What you guys are presenting, $2,500 cut, is actually less than level funding my budget.
How do you figure that?
You take out the one-time purchase of the taser, that brings me to a $2,200 increase in my budget. Mm-hmm. You're cutting 25, so that's $300 more than what I'm looking for an increase.
Wait, but what's the impact on the department? That's what we're looking at.
As far as the taser goes?
If you don't get the money, what's the negative impact on the department that is going to affect the department so that the town of Whately is less secure or less protected than what it would be with the $2,500?
Yeah. Well, the budget, the way it was presented, that covers the shifts. The other increases, like the clothing allowance, it wouldn't have a detrimental effect if we cut $500 from there. That was just me coming in saying, it hasn't been increased in 20 years for the clothing allowance. So looking for $250 per person, right, so we could better, you know, equip ourselves, have more money for uniforms, better equipment, things like that. So yes, it's not detrimental, but it's my job to look at what, as far as the police department goes, to have the best equipment, not secondhand equipment, not stuff that's ripped and torn. So yeah, it's not detrimental, but that was the reason for looking for that increase. Some of the things, our fees go up as far as dues. If those change, just like things change with other people's budgets, those are out of my control. I'm not looking for something else, it's just an increase. We had an $850 increase in the radio maintenance. That wasn't by my doing, that was the regional council of governments added $850, because that's what they needed to maintain the system. Mm-hmm. So I wasn't looking for a lot of increases. These increases that, I mean, the taser, the one-time purchase of the taser and adding some for the cartridges to be able to train and qualify each officer, that's part of that $500 item in the ammo section, and then the increase in the clothing allowance. Those are the only two real increases in the budget. Everything else is kind of out of my control. I mean, without going through every single specific item, I mean, training costs go up, office supplies go up. This is the first year we're paying for maintaining our own building. It's always come out of town building account. This is the first year we're doing that. We did the floors, and I realized after the first time we did the floors that we're short some money. So I had to add $500 to be able to do the work on the floors that we needed to be able to do to keep maintaining the building, keep the floors in good shape. So that was kind of halfway through the year of paying for the building. Now it's part of my budget. You know, that's the same thing with electrical, you know, expenses. That was reduced a little bit. We talked about it with the selectmen's meeting, and they said, well, that's a little bit high. Why is it so high? Well, that got raised up by the previous town administrator because rates were supposed to spike. They didn't spike as much, so we didn't need that much money for the utility expenses, so it was cut down a little bit. So there's nothing in the budget that I'm looking for, new initiatives, new programs, you know, a new officer, new patrols. It's just a couple of little things, and the rest of it is kind of part of doing business. Well, it is. I mean, you can laugh about it, but it is. It's, yep. Dues go up, ammo costs go up. Ammo costs have gone up 70% since I started.
Right, right.
We still have to qualify.
We understand, and everything you've mentioned is obviously the cost of doing business as a police department. There's nothing, the only thing that actually jumps out on this budget that's new and is, well, just happens to be the taser.
Yeah, oh, absolutely.
Because if you take that out,
it's a controversial topic too.
You've got a 5% increase and you got a $9,200 increase in the total dollars for the budget. Okay. So that's, so everything else is just basically cost of doing business in town, and...
And we were donated two tasers, that's why we haven't deployed tasers, somebody donated two tasers to us. Is it detrimental if we don't have three? No. But three is ideal, because three would be used equal amounts. Me having one, Don having one, one for the full-time officers, and one for everybody else to share, it's equal amounts of shifts. Because if you have one, you're gonna add wear and tear to it, and you're gonna have to maintain it, you're gonna have to replace it more often. So that's the reasoning behind adding that one taser. Is it detrimental? No. Since I've been here 17 years that I've been in this department, we haven't had tasers.
Right.
We've had other departments that have had tasers that have used them. So yes, I mean, you don't wanna be the one that's out on the street having to deal with somebody and you don't have a taser, because then you have other claims for excessive force and things like that. So again, it's part of doing business. Society's changing. People want to see less lethal options. They don't want to see people getting shot. They want to see using less lethal options. So that's why somebody donated it to us. Would I have come to the town and said, we need to buy three tasers this year at a cost of, $5,000? Probably not, but because somebody donated it, I'm looking to start that initiative. It's a public safety thing, it's an officer safety thing.
So I'll be honest, I was the one that I guess really started that conversation. And I think you've done a good job of explaining your budget, and we did go through the budget, but we tried to level things out a little bit. And when you're trying to, the increase in the uniform allowance, that's one of those things. Yeah, I support it. I think that's the right thing to do. You just can't do it all in one year is the way that I look at it. The taser part of things is the town is not without it. There are two.
Yeah.
I appreciate what you're saying about the wear and tear,
the cruiser,
and all that. But I started with the taser. And so people started saying, well, geez, how can we don't want to tell them what you can and can't spend as many money on.
Yep.
And so that's when we said, well, where do we look at, how do we justify this? And that's when we said, well, let's get them to 5%. He's at 6.25%, whatever it is. And so that's where the $2,500 came from. And we certainly don't want to tell you what you can and can't spend your money. But backing into it, I was the one that started up about the taser, and that it's $1,200 for that. It's the other things, and I guess maybe I should have seen it coming, but you certainly weren't singled out. It looks like it, but we weren't saying let's go after the police department because it wasn't. Jonathan had mentioned that the percentages and the dollars. Yeah, there's higher percentages out there. The dollars weren't there, but they also came in and explained. I mean,
not everybody, Joe. Tri-Town Beach didn't come in.
Oh, you're right. You're right. The ones that came in, yep, you're right.
Right.
And so now we're just going to forget something else because we didn't bring somebody else in.
No, I guess.
Yes, that's what you're saying, Jonathan.
No, I'm expressing my frustration that people who don't come in to defend their budget get their budget. That's my frustration.
And it's a frustrating thing as a whole because it's one of those budgets that aren't just a Whately budget.
I know. I mean,
we get a number, but it's not just a Whately budget.
It's a Whately asset, though.
Right, and we sat here one night and said, how do we fix this? And when the time crunch that we have, you can't just fix it in the time that we have to fix it. And maybe shame on us that we didn't push hard to get them in here to do that, but there's only so many meetings that you can have in getting people here and coordinating. And I appreciate
all right.
that.
We have a department that has come in that is asking for a refunding. Is that what you're doing? You're asking for a...
He wants his $2,500 back. That's
okay.
What he wants. But.
Well, I didn't know that the $2,500 was gone. I mean, I'm just...
Well, it is right now.
Well, from the Finance Committee, but the Select Board wasn't on the same page.
Actually, it's the town that decides.
Yeah, well, absolutely.
We recommend,
absolutely.
It goes on the floor,
yeah.
And then there's a vote. So it's the town.
Yeah.
So
well, they're going to get one number.
Correct. So what we have right now is we have the ability to revote this. Okay. But we, if my memory serves me, we also have to vote to have duly voted. So amongst the Finance Committee members, I'd like to have a motion to revote the police budget.
For the purpose of changing what?
For the purpose of...
Reinstating 2,500?
Yes.
I don't know. I think that maybe if we turn around and what, whatever the cost of that taser is, I don't think we need the third taser, but we aren't supposed to be dictating their budget.
No.
So I mean, let's ask the guy who really matters. I mean, would you, I mean, let's just throw it out there to everybody. I mean, I don't want to take, he explained that he has expenses that have gone up, right? If you guys feel that the 2,500 is, or the presented budget is appropriate, that's fine. I will make a motion that we...
To revote.
Revoke, the Finance Committee revoke, that we decrease the police department budget by $1,200 from the $2,500 that we, which basically earmarks, you know. But I guess that's why I wanted to ask you. I mean, is that, does that work for you, or do we just say, I mean, I don't agree with that increase.
I agree with that statement. I agree with that.
So, but I certainly don't want to tell you what to do with your money.
Yeah, I have a budget to work with, and if you say that I've got $1,200 less, does that mean I'm not going to buy the taser? No.
No.
That's because it's not a line item thing. I mean, if you guys are looking at taking out the taser, you're saying that you don't want to look at a specific line.
I'm not looking at taking out the taser. I'm looking at cutting $2,500.
Which is more than level funded. It's cutting less than level funded, which has never happened since I've been doing the budget.
I don't. That doesn't make sense to me. That it's less than level funded.
Well, you're trying to cut $2,500.
Yeah.
And if you take out the taser...
That leaves you a 5% increase.
That gives you $9,200 more
than you had last year.
Yeah, but that's salaries. If you
how
look
much
at,
of that is salaries?
Salary. All that minus $2,200, which is what's left.
Yeah.
You had a breakdown.
Yeah. Yes, I did.
So 161,000 is salary.
$168,280 is the salary for the police department. And you had in salaries, you had a 5.18% increase. So we can, that $2,500 can come off and you can still make your salary.
Yeah.
How much dollar increase was the salary?
$7,916.
These aren't exact figures. I mean, if you look at like the cruiser, what we've been paying to fix the cruiser, we've been going over that amount. So I have to pull that from somewhere else in order just to pay for that. So looking at a specific item, saying that we can take the 1,200 and you'd still fund your salaries, but that's my job. That's my responsibility to figure out if we need to cut a shift or two, or if, you know, if we take a vacation or a sick day, that shift doesn't get filled. You know, those are the types of things we can do throughout the year. That's why I'm saying it's not detrimental. Somebody asked me before if I thought it was fair. Yes, I feel that the budget's fair. This is what I feel we need. I don't think I'm looking for extreme.
So what are we trying to decide? Whether we're going forward or staying with the same budget?
Right.
That's what we're trying to.
Why don't we just stay with the same budget and move forward?
Well, because that also. Because first I want to determine if there's enough interest amongst the Finance Committee to revisit that budget.
You're going to revisit the budget, you're going to come up with the same solution.
What's that?
To cut the 2,500.
Well, I don't know that.
But we don't have a motion to change it, so.
No, so let's just leave it as is.
Just leave it as is.
I was just, I was gonna make a motion to leave it at 2,500, but we don't even need to do that. We just leave it.
You don't, right, right.
But I was, just another point of interest, I was looking at the 3,450 number, that's my total increase for the operating portion of the budget. That's the number I was going by, 3,450 for the general police department section. That's my overall increase.
I got 38.
Subtracting 2,500 from that, from 3,400, that's, again, that's taking more than what would be level funded.
So if we took the 2,500 from that, then that leaves you with $1,300 increase in general police department.
Yeah, but taking the taser off of that, if you take the 1,200 from the taser, 1,200 minus 3,400, that gets you to 2,200. Then you're taking 2,500 from there. So it's looking at my expenses, my, minus the taser, that seemed to be the issue, minus the taser, it's only $2,200. So it's a little, yeah, yours is a little bit more than.
Well, because we added in the FCAT radio maintenance. That's probably what the difference is, that's why this one's higher.
Yeah, because that was in, because that was like 850, I think that was in this one too.
Oh, we're showing 3,850.
Yep.
I see 3,850. If I have no motion to revote the police budget.
This doesn't have the FCAT yet.
Then we will move on.
That's a $900 difference.
The last, the only other thing that can be done if we don't revote it here is it can be brought out on town floor and have it voted right there to have the increase put back in. I mean, it can be done.
You can get up on town meeting floor and explain why you think you need the other 2,500 for the taser and for whatever else, and then it will be put to a vote on town meeting floor. You can say, you know, you can say it wasn't recommended by the finance committee or however you want to do it. And then the town meeting can change it, and then it's out of our control. We're just making a recommendation, that's all.
That's our job, is to recommend. People vote on it.
Yep.
If the selectmen were to, I'm not, I don't know what their opinion is, but if they were to recommend a different, if they were to recommend keeping that 2,500, what would show up on town meeting floor?
Yeah.
Two numbers, would it be?
It could say.
I don't know how that.
They would have to bring it up to change it.
Oh, okay.
But it could say that selectmen recommend original budget.
We signed the articles, I think.
Because I know in the past, I mean, the finance committee hasn't recommended something, but it's still been.
Recommended by you guys.
That's because no one, no one came up in back of it and said.
Yeah, on town meeting floor.
I want to vote, we want to vote this other number in.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it can be done.
Schools have done it.
Schools have done it.
No, we haven't.
Absolutely.
No.
Yes, you have.
No, wait a minute, I'll explain that in a minute, Paul.
How about Monty's budget last year?
Let me explain, okay?
Go ahead.
I think you've got to put a figure in there, the higher figure, and you can decrease that. You can't put a figure in there and then increase it on the town floor. I don't think you can do that.
He may be right.
You may be right.
I'm 99% sure.
Is that just the schools, or that's?
No, I think that's everything. So if you want to look at this and take it to a town vote, I would recommend that you put in the higher figure, the 2,500 that he requested. Then somebody from the finance committee gets up and says, we're recommending 2,500 less, and go, you know, vote that figure. But I believe you have to have the highest figure. You can't increase it in town meeting, it's kind of where it's coming at.
Yeah, it doesn't. I would have to get somebody smart like me.
Again, I brought it up for.
Most people don't pay any.
What's your take on that?
You're on the hot seat.
Well, I'll have to double check when you ask it, but My understanding is that amounts can be increased, but it needs to be within reason or it's outside the scope of warrant.
What does in reason mean? Is there a percentage number or?
Not really.
There could be a percentage, there'd have to be a, you know, shit.
So, I mean, it goes back to whether somebody who read the warrant has noticed that that amount of money was going to be discussed. So if you take it from, if you take it from $10,000 to $80,000, it's probably not going to happen, but smaller adjustments, I think.
Can be made.
But I'm, again, that's going to be called the moderator as well, but we'll have to check with.
Good point, Don.
Well, I'm just looking out for the town, Paul.
I know you always do.
I don't want our police department suing our town for our.
Suing the finance committee.
We're voting on the whole budget, we're not, right, no, it's not the police department budget, we're not recommending, we're not recommending, so we're not going to vote on anything right now.
No.
And I think Don's right, actually, but you should check.
And we don't want to get into a town meeting policy where we line item every vote, because that's why Deerfield has two-day town.
That's right, we don't want that.
That's why we're.
No offense, we're so close in the neighboring town.
It'd be a good send-off for Paul.
Thanks. We're so close, I want this meeting to go smoothly.
All right, Mr. Chair, what's next?
Okay, folks, that was an excellent discussion, bringing that up.
Come on to the next one.
I got a couple more things for you.
Now, because there's a concert at 7 that I've got to be at, so. Do you want to talk about that while I'm not going to be there?
You want to talk about my life?
All right, there were, okay, go ahead.
Two other things to talk about in the operations budget since we've last met. One is I received a revised budget from South County Senior Center. Revised up.
Revised up?
Revised up.
Boy.
How's that possible?
From the original one that we have to the one that was sent to me.
The line went down 18%.
Well, I know it wasn't a discussion of the Board of Oversight.
That increased her, it was essentially personnel, I'll move on this personnel step. So that was explained to me.
So what's the bottom line there?
She's a town, it was explained to me that she's a town Deerfield employee.
That's true.
And that's where they felt that a step increase was.
Which amounts?
I think our share was $700 increase.
Well, that's still going to be a negative change.
Because Deerfield gave her a step increase, our share of it is going to be $700.
You notice the theme with our regional.
Yeah, right. And Sunderland's portion would be 7 and Deerfield's would be about 14, because it's a 50-25-25 split.
Yeah.
We're making a list of regional entities that we probably.
What's their plan? What's their plan for the senior center? What's their plan?
In what sense?
You know what sense I'm talking about.
The building?
Yeah.
Right now, the plan is to move to the church, and at some point, the town of Deerfield is going to probably renovate their building.
What's the plan for the, what's going to be the cost of Whately to renovate the church?
Hasn't been discussed.
Brian, so with this increase, it's something to whatever, what, $700?
Yeah, it's a friggin' dump.
So.
That's shown in budget four, that's shown in both budgets, that's included in both.
Oh, it's included already?
That's included in here.
All right, so if we approve whatever this is.
Use the fire trap.
So what would you like us to do, Brian?
Just know that that increase is in there.
Okay.
Because when you adopt the, we don't want any surprises.
Okay, are we.
That's in this right here?
It's included in there, yeah.
Remember that .14?
Yep.
Okay, everything that we do, we have to know how it affects that .14.
Yep, you got it, right here.
It's still .14.
It's .14, but we're bumping up that.
What, we're taking out of free cash?
No, we're bumping up, it's .14, whatever it is now.
.14.8
now.
Yeah, instead of .145 or whatever it was.
That's correct.
Yeah, there's.
We're coming up on 15 cents.
The budget projection is here.
Yeah.
The other item that was changed around was There was an original capital item, and this is something for you guys to decide if you want to do it or not. It was not a capital item. There was an original transfer from free cash that we talked about for the benefit payout of a retiring employee.
Yes.
That was $12,000. I had conversations with Keith about the employee's retirement and hiring of a new employee. And he recommended that we take out $2,000, so we reduce that item to $10,000, the benefits payout. He had more discussions about his vacation and things like that as to how much we expect to do out. And he was wondering, well, he recommended that we move $2,000 to cover the cost of the new hire. That would.
What's the cost of the new hire? That
I think it had to do with if there's any overlapping of the retiring employee for the new employee for training purposes.
The training?
Yeah.
So where does the $2,000 go?
Yeah,
I'm getting confused $2,000 because he shows him how to get around.
Probably. He would stick around longer, or the hire would happen sooner.
Because. The employee who's going to retire would be collecting salary, and the new hire would be collecting salary at the same time.
I wouldn't think we would hire a new employee until the old one is
no kidding.
Gone. Number one. Number two is, I'm not 100% sure, but I think the new employee is going to start at the bottom of the pay scale. He's not going to start at the same rate that the guy that's retiring is getting.
Correct.
So there's not a lot of training involved in how to use a shovel and how to use a rake. And if you don't have a class 2 or class B, you're not going to get hired. You're supposed to have a hoister's license, or you're not going to get hired. There's not a lot of training involved. You ought to be pretty well trained already. Yeah. We're not hiring a 16-year-old.
My feeling is that this is something that the select board, who oversee that department, should be advising that department on how to hire and how to train and how not to impact the budget any more than
that. And if he can't find $2,000 in his budget,
but
to train somebody either in salaries or something else.
So that's not ours.
What did we do with the new water superintendent? Billy was still on part-time until the new one.
That was because of the license.
That had to do with licensing.
Was that because of license? Or
and in the end,
training.
Then you have to have a backup. That's, I think that's what.
Well, wasn't Wayne the backup?
Yeah. Originally, when Billy was still working.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. In terms of the operation budget. That was it.
Okay, capital budget.
Refer back to the sheet.
Right.
Finance committee post changes additions. FY18 capital budget. Split the proposed purchase of turnout gear for the fire department over a 2-year period. At $30,500 each year. So this wanted to be an item of discussion.
One of the points brought up by the chief, who is here, I believe,
yes, he is,
was that if we don't buy all the equipment before December 31st, correct me if I'm wrong, the price goes up by 5%. So it would be cheaper, given the rate of inflation is less than 5%, to buy it, maybe buy them all this year, as opposed to splitting it over a 2-year period, which made sense to me.
One of the reasons we discussed breaking it down into 2 years was that we don't know what the grant situation is or any additional funding for these things. We were hoping that if we got $30,500 and got half of them this year, the funding was going to be looked at in the fall or something.
We can explore whatever grant opportunities are out there.
How do you decide which half gets them?
Well, that's one of John's arguments. So we decide who gets them.
It's not our job, not ours.
Yeah, same old. That's not our job.
So, John, if you got a grant, let's say we got let's say we got all the suits this year, you could still apply for a grant for other purposes, for general support?
Well, then you just want more money.
Yeah.
Well...
No, that would be hard to do.
Yeah, grants are typically...
The grant is specific to the year.
Yeah, okay.
And you're thinking around fall that was going to come in?
Well, that's when they're due. They're due to be written, and I don't know that they've actually awarded last year's grants yet, today.
Mm-hmm. I think the other reason I guess Select Board was commenting on this was I think we thought it was more important to buy the gear for the fire department than the school's request. For one, we thought it was higher priority, and second, we weren't sure exactly what the school's request was for. We were speculating whether it was clocks or alarms or telephones or internet service or whatever, and we don't remember seeing any detail on that, so it was like a wish to do something, whereas we had the fire department something real that...
I would say I think we went back and we took a look at the verbiage of... And it said that it was recommended by, as far as this turnout gear goes. So I thought we were gonna have somebody look into that, whether it was something that this gear is absolutely no good, or it was just recommended that after 10 years that it's replaced.
Well, that would argue for not doing it at all, because you don't want, why buy even half of it if it's not?
Well, but it's, whatever, it's 10 years old, and so at some point you're going to start replacing it.
Well, it's actually older than that, right? It's 13 years old, and it's a 10-year lifespan on stuff.
According to the National Fire Protection Association.
Now, the question is...
Again, it was a key word recommended.
The question to the chief, as far as we were concerned, is does that compromise the safety of the firefighters in any way? And, does it hold us liable for potential problems?
Absolutely, and yes. I believe both.
Okay. And so that's what we heard. So then we thought, if we take $30,000 from the school budget for the clock and the intercom, so that'll cover the cost of the second batch, and we could buy them both in 1 year.
Well, I understand that, but there's a couple of questions concerning, number one, prior to this, whatever turnout gear the fire department had, who paid for that?
Oh, that was a grant that I wrote.
Okay.
15 years ago.
Oh, okay, so we haven't paid for that, did we match that?
It wasn't matched. It was like
That was the result of 9/11, right? When they come out with the grants available for years.
No, that gear was in, the gear we have now was manufactured in 2005.
Okay.
I wrote that grant when they first started coming out with the grants for the fire department, and since that time, it's changed more with a regional concept. I mean, if I wrote a grant for a region, I might get it, but I don't believe that I would get a grant today for protective clothing.
Okay, now the protective clothing, the turnout gear that we're looking at here for this price tag, is there only one? Or is there a myriad of choices for quality in terms of the gear that we would purchase?
Oh, there's...
So is there a Kmart one, and is there a, you know...
Yeah, there's Carhartt, there's Levi, there's Wrangler.
Right. So which one is this getting?
Oh, I contacted the guy I do all my business with. That's on I think he's looking at Globe as the name brand. And I got to be middle of the line, at least. I wouldn't buy the cheapest thing on him, and I wouldn't buy the Cadillac.
Can I ask a question? What was it discussed by you guys to finance it over 2 years and just buy it all out, right? Because it's $30,000, so it's not going to be a tremendous hit.
No, it wasn't. I think what it was it was the grant that it really was, you know, a lot of these things, you know, we try to gear up for it.
Right.
You know, over a period of time, and it was kind of this came in at a $70,000 capital.
You know, in terms of trading this off for the clocks in the school, I think, I don't see that as being a trade-off.
Why?
No.
Well, because I think just from the security aspect within the school building itself, should there be an emergency, this should be able, that school should be able to have crisp, clear communication to every room in that building at any time. And they don't have it right now.
That's a bigger safety consideration for the schools for that.
Absolutely.
You've got more kids there, and if something happens, you got to get them out.
Didn't your firefighters' lives?
That's pretty subjective.
That's a tough call to make, Dan.
I don't want to do this.
Why? I understand what you're doing, Paul.
I really don't. Because they're all important. There's no lives that are not important.
I guess.
But we have adults who volunteered for something, and we have children who are mandated to do something and think that somebody's going to protect them at all times.
Here's my question, and what I don't entirely get, I guess. And it's a difference of opinion, I get it. The Finance Committee's job is to talk about what is fiscally responsible for the town. How much can we spend in a given year? It is not the Finance Committee's job to make the decision as to what is spent on that money, with that money.
Well, if that's the case, we should just give you a dollar amount.
Well, you spend it where you want.
Is that statute? Are you quoting a statute? Okay. Let me tell you what the Finance Committee's job is.
Well,
the job is by statute, is to create the budget and present it to town.
Based upon the town's ability to pay, not based upon policy priorities.
It's a question of value. Sometimes you can't pay for everything. And sometimes you have to make decisions as to whether you're going left or whether you're going right.
Point is that the legislative body of this town is the town's people.
Absolutely.
It's not you and it's not us.
Exactly. So all we can do is make recommendation, and what we're deciding here is the recommendation. We're not deciding the yes or the no of it. We're just deciding what words are going to be put on this document, and that's all.
And unfortunately, what happens is on town meeting floor, Paul, and I don't think we're that far off from agreement here. But what happens on town meeting floor? That means that it's not a fun discussion between the safety of first responders and the safety of children.
No, it's not.
No. But that's what we're putting the people who come to town meeting. The only 100 people out of our 900 and something voters who choose to show up for town meeting. That's putting them in a very awkward position.
You're absolutely right. And
I have a question for John when you get a chance.
Go ahead. I'm a little dry.
What is the number of suits? Turnout gear that you're going to buy. How many?
At $61,000?
How many?
Tell me what you're funding.
Well, this is what we're trying to
say. Whatever you request.
What I'm trying to say is...
I requested 26. Since then, I've had 3 people leave.
How many is that?
That would be 23.
For $61,000, it's 23 turnout.
Yep.
Wasn't it 70-something thousand?
And then I had 3 guys quit.
73.
That was what you had to put before you asked, after you asked?
I put in my capital request in December.
But when we had you in here, we asked, okay, how many of these, we've got a long...
2 had left, and since I've lost enough...
We had a long list, and we asked how many are active.
Yep.
And you came back and shaved a couple off of that. So you were at 70-something thousand, now you're at 61,000.
Right.
Is that correct?
Yep.
And then since that 61, you've lost some?
No, that was in that time frame.
Okay.
For my original request.
And I guess the last question I have is, nobody's told me that this stuff is outdated. It is recommended that these changes be made. Recommended. It's not saying that we throw this stuff away in the dumpster. It is recommended, and the change happened. Did they say this had a lifespan of 10 or 13 years? It came to you across your desk prior to this budget season and capital season that it is going to be outdated. It's recommended that it be replaced. Nobody is saying that. Answer me, why is it better? What is better than what you have right now? What part, what are you going to be buying that's going to make this better than what you have right now?
It's new equipment.
It was new, okay, so I know it's new.
Yeah, I understand that it's new, Joe. And what has happened since we bought this equipment was, obviously, people have gotten hurt. The equipment has failed. And the National Fire Protection Association now recommends that if it's 10 years old, it's unserviceable. And after that, I can't help you.
Well, John, so if people are getting hurt, we didn't hear that before.
The equipment is failing.
How much of the original equipment you said you bought 12 years ago is still being used?
All of it.
All but like two sets?
All except two sets.
Two or three sets, yeah, that I have replaced in that time frame.
I would like to hear from the school committee about the clocks, the intercom, whatever this is involved in, because we're just guessing at what that means. That you're replacing. Could you tell us what's the status of what's there today and why it needs replacing and what you're going to replace it with?
So this is a request that we put in last year. So we didn't get funding last year, and we were told we would get it this year. So the first thing I want to say is if we get bumped again, we're going to have to refresh that price because that's going to be 3 years out, and that isn't going to be a sufficient
amount. He's asking why they need to be replaced.
Well, because the equipment we have in there is as old as the building. It's the initial building, so that's what, 21 years old? What was the building?
It was built in 90. We moved in 90.
It has never been replaced.
But
that's not the reason. No. Tell them the reason
want to expand our security, because right now you cannot call 911 from a classroom.
That's the reason.
You can't. You have to have your own cell phone, and some of those rooms don't have self-service in them. So those rooms are totally cut off from any communication in an emergency. Another inconvenient thing is our voicemail is down. So it is one system. It's phones, clocks, and bells.
So what are you going to replace it with? Now, I understand it's one system, but
replace it with a system that will have an all call. So all classrooms will be able to use their phones for outside calls, and you can call from classroom to classroom. Right now, we can only call from office to one classroom. So if there's an emergency in one end of the building, at least those two classrooms could communicate with each other in an emergency, which we don't have that right now. So it's improving the equipment that we have. And what we put in 1990, security has changed. We have our lockdown drills. There is a risk that we wouldn't be able to communicate.
How many other schools in the district have that?
We're starting to replace all of them. There's a request in at Deerfield that we do the same thing, and Sunderland, I believe, we also have a request. No, not Conway. We're doing it. We have a request to do it in Conway this year as well. So all the schools. And we're doing Frontiers as well.
So I guess my feeling as a select board member is that, and listening to all this, we're sort of cannibalizing ourselves in a way at the expense of either public safety or public health or both. And I think the taxpayers of Whately would agree that having a secure security system for the school should be a priority. And I believe they would also agree that having safety for firefighters, maybe saving their homes, is worth spending money on also. And if that means bumping up the budget a little bit, I think people would go for it. I think this is not irresponsible spending. I mean, I think we're squeezing blood out of a rock here to some degree. We have a large budget, and we're talking about the taser. Yeah, I could go either way with the taser. I don't think that's necessary personally. So, but I think the firefighting and the security of the schools should be a pretty high priority. Yeah.
Just one of the little things at our school that came to our attention this year was the curtain where we have town meeting, that curtain right there. They told us either we had to buy a new one this year or get it fire resistant again because it was outdated. So to listen to something over here that's outdated already, and we're talking about a curtain that's probably all right still, but we're told that we have to spend $600 to refreshing it for fire safety.
They get down and throw it in the dumpster.
Well, they say, but a new one's going to cost a lot more than this, but we could send it out and get it, but I'm just saying, but we were talking about something that's outdated. We're talking about a curtain. And we're talking about safety.
Patty's telling me 15 grand for a new curtain. Fire retardant.
You know, because they don't use the stage.
But I'm just saying, with $600 to refresh it, but we're talking about his equipment that probably is outdated.
My point was that, you know, it, I think from the select board's point of view, correct me if I'm wrong, Fred, John's not here anymore, but I think from a policy point of view, it makes good policy sense to within limits, do what we can to maintain public safety and the security of our kids in the school. And unfortunately, you know, these things come year after year, it's always something. So, and we're gonna try to improve our capital budgeting process so we don't run into these things where all of a sudden we need to replace all the outfits or two cruisers instead of one. And if we can space this stuff out more judiciously in the future, then we won't have these discussions about, you know, I know every bit, every penny counts, but we're talking a few thousand bucks here, a few thousand bucks there, and it all adds up to real money. But compared to what? The price of safety in the schools and the price of safety of our firefighters, I think that's a good deal, even though it's a little more expensive once we get it straightened out and we get these uniforms or outfits or whatever. We get the intercom system fixed, that'll last for another 20 years. We get the cruiser or whatever, and then we do what we're gonna do with deal with further down the sheet here, is try to come up with some sort of scheduled funding, putting money aside every year to prevent us from running into these things where all of a sudden we need to, boom, buy it all at once and we don't have any money saved.
The other issue here really is that this came in, John's request came in as a last minute request. There was no planning, it just came in. And, you know, whoever, whatever reason, you can't deal with futuristic things if you can't plan for that.
Well, sometimes, yeah, there's emergencies, right?
And so this is unusual. The school asked last year for the phone system. You know, we asked again this year, and that's where we're at.
So what do you have like at the front door right now going into the elementary school?
As far as
intercoms, as far as locks and things like that.
Camera and
airlock.
Camera and buzzer lock.
So that's what I was going to say. I mean, the building security, you have to be
communication that we're worried about.
So, I mean, I guess one thing that I was looking at going forward, and I agree with what you're talking about, going through what Brian said the other day, I said, well, geez, maybe we should start pumping more money into capital stabilization. And now we're not going to be, this year, I would say we're not going to do it if we fund these two projects, but they certainly, I appreciate both John and school as well. But that money that I would have been recommending that we pump in to those two capital stabilization, it is probably going to get eaten up by this.
It's going to capital project away, whether it's this year or down the road.
So can we just have the thought is we've got 16.5 still left over from the sale of the cell tower that's in capital stabilization. Put that towards the fire request. And
maybe.
Maybe.
It's a restricted fund.
Yeah.
We might have to switch
on conditions.
It has conditions as to what it can be spent on.
And then just keep what we have here in this capital project recommendations that we've already discussed ad nauseum. Just keep that the way it is, and then the phone clock intercom the school stays there. And
what's the number on that? The phone clock intercom?
30K.
That's why it was going to be half the uniforms. Right. So we thought we'll spend it on that. We'll get them all in one fell swoop and avoid the 5% increase.
So there's a sheet statement of account balances here that's been updated.
So it's 30 grand for sure. What if it's less? Or what if it's more?
We'll have another meeting.
Great.
Okay. And you're proposing that we fund both at the 30,000 school and at 60 for the
fire. We know it's 30.
Is that what you're proposing?
Yeah.
Okay, I support what you're proposing as a select board, that we support funding both at the full level that they asked for.
Okay. Brian?
Yeah.
Are we good on that?
Funding for both, say yes.
Funding for both?
Yes.
Yes. Take a peek at this sheet right here, statement of account balances.
Yes, I know.
8A.
It's in D.
AB.
AB.
Statement of account balances. Looks like. Free cash balance, $545,490. The FY18 capital expenditures, that includes that $123,250. Includes the school, the IT, which was reduced to in half. Mixed paper compactor, protective equipment, all the protective equipment. Police cruiser account and highway garage, that's $123,250.
Yep.
If we were to take that all out of free cash plus the $200,000 to reduce the tax levy, if we're going to vote that, plus the retirement benefits payout, $10,000, if we're going to vote that, that's what our balance would be remaining to the right in free cash.
$212,240.
For comparison, last year, the balance was, after the appropriations, was $239,679.
We're close.
We're close.
Close enough.
It's better than that.
Approximately that's what we would have.
Yep.
If it were to all come from.
If we're able to use the cell phone for the $16,000 from that for something, and take the free cash down to $200,000 even, that just about level, takes it to $29,000 or so of the $30,000 that we're.
The whole 60 is in this $123,000.
Correct.
Oh, the whole.
It's already in.
Well, no, that's, we're not talking about 60, we're talking 90, we're talking 60 for the fire and 30.
That is all in there.
It's all in.
That 90's, okay, that's all in there.
This $123,250 includes $30,000 for the.
Oh, I thought that was just.
Okay.
No.
$97,50 IT, $61,000, $5,000.
So the budget as presented includes full. Okay.
All right. I say we move on.
Move on.
Brian? What's next? Do we have anything?
Well, when you mean the full budget, the capital, there were two items, there's $10,000 for the, that are listed here, $10,000 for the police vehicle replacement account. That's included with that $123,500.
Good luck with that.
Then there was discussions about $500 for repairs on highway garage.
What are they going to do there?
You and I can do it.
So the police vehicle replacement account, the Selectboard generally supported.
Yep.
And in terms of the highway garage, it was probably a little premature. Is that fair, Fred, you think?
Yes, we have no idea what you're going to do with the $5,000 and.
I don't think we're planning on doing anything.
We weren't planning.
We're just putting it in an account.
Somebody said they needed a roof, they needed a floor.
Why put it in an account for them? Why not for the fire station? Why not for police station?
What difference does it make?
Why?
It's going to flip, it's going to flip with the free cash if we don't spend it.
Yeah, I mean, you do that at home.
You want to put it in stabilization?
Well, that's basically what we're doing.
We can put it in capital stabilization, right?
It's earmarked for the highway garage.
And you're saying for the highway garage.
Right, because we know that repairs and maintenance of the highway garage are staring us in the face in the next.
Others could be as well, and we don't know that until we're changing our process of looking at capital improvements for next year. I mean, the highway garage may not be the top priority, something else could come up.
And you're right, we had this discussion last week about it, and I said, well, geez, I mean, at what point, what is the number that we stop putting money in there? And just to have it earmarked for a project is great, but we need to keep on pumping money in to overall capital stabilization. So, I mean, I was going either way on it, and I think the number was thrown out at around $30,000 or something for the building or needs, or there was a roof, there was.
Probably $35,000 or $40,000.
And so, I mean, I'm not going to get into the details because it doesn't really matter, but I think it is important to continue to put, and whether we just put that into capital stabilization or we earmark it for the town garage, I think we need to start funding that.
Right.
I guess you could look at the vehicle replacement account for.
We did this before, years ago, we did this for the ambulance. We put in so much, every year for it. It just earmarked it.
Right.
So the money was there at the top, but it just earmarked for that.
It's earmarked. We can, you can vote to do other things. We can change it. I mean, you can take it out.
Standard way of doing it. We've been doing it for years.
The building could fall down.
Yeah, then we got to build a brand new building.
It has to go.
So you're saying you're taking, you're earmarking it for highway garage or not?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, because we think that's the prudent thing to do as time goes on. When you have things downstream that you foresee you will have to pay for, and then instead of one big chunk coming out of one year,
just do a study.
You have a little in the kitty.
I think the study's going to tell you to.
It's called pre-plan.
But if it comes out next year, that's not the.
That's not going to affect.
Then we'll change it. Then we can move it.
We can move it to that fire station.
Exactly.
If that comes out.
Exactly.
So that $5,000 going into capital stabilization.
Yeah,
that would be my recommendation. But earmarked.
Earmarked.
Yeah.
Air quotes earmarked.
Yeah,
right.
Like we used to do with the ambulance.
Would the police vehicle replacement account be the same?
No, right.
More or less, yeah, same thing. It's earmarked for.
It's earmarked, but it's sitting in an account that.
Well, I think that's different. Then, you know, we can put it in, like Dan had said about, we had $20,000 a year that was going into the ambulance, and we could do other things with it, but it was an account that went in there.
Yeah.
It was voted on every year. Capital stabilization account is different than just putting it in there and saying, we're hoping that this $5,000 is going to go to something. So, I mean, are we looking at putting it into the capital stabilization account, or are we putting it into a capital account for a new cruiser or for the highway garage?
No. Well, the cruiser is going into an account for a new cruiser.
Yep.
Why do we need a separate account just for a new cruiser?
Because we're going to get a new cruiser
every four years.
Okay, you also got, the highway department needs a new vehicle every so often. Where is their account for that?
That is debt excluded.
Yeah, you don't want
it. When you spend $150,000 to $200,000.
Not a truck, though, a pickup truck or whatever he's got, it doesn't last forever either. I don't know what
but the,
cycle
well, the
he's
police
on.
Cruisers are much more predictable.
We should do it. We're not doing it
one step at a time.
We haven't got to that point yet this year. It's too late for this year.
Maybe next year.
And whether, I guess, some point we'll decide whether the vehicle replacement should be part of the capital improvement program overall, looking at building maintenance.
You're absolutely right. And I'm pretty sure it is, right?
Yeah. No. It does come up in short term. I mean, we're not looking at the long term. It's only a year or two ahead.
No, we're looking at 10 years. We have a 10-year projection for a vehicle replacement.
And we talked about
at the highway department.
We talked about that in the facility.
But then things come up.
Yeah.
They are on the capital planning now. Cruisers and trucks and pickups.
I don't have that.
Okay.
All right, let's go.
All right,
okay.
One more thing. Not to beat a dead horse.
Go ahead.
But I want to make sure we're going to give him the 60 whatever thousand for the new turnout gear, but he has got to apply for grants. If he gets the grants, God bless him. If he doesn't, he's gone. But this isn't a blank check to go out and spend $60,000 to buy turnout gear. There's probably a 10% chance we'll get a grant, but 10% is better than nothing.
I mean, he's going to do it. He said he's going to do it.
Well, I think every head of department has to look out for that kind of stuff. And we're in.
We give him the money, and the money's going to be gone. Basically.
It's awesome. Right.
It may be he can apply for a grant because we've already spent the money.
And if we see them with a new boat,
the new boat's out back.
We have a boat.
Hiding it out.
You might see fishing outriggers on that thing.
Oh, what else?
All right, Brian?
Other stuff? Yeah. Did we vote for the benefits payout for the entire retiring employee for $10,000?
What does it entail?
That entails.
How much on a dollar?
100%.
That's not right.
for sick time. When you retire, you get paid 8 hours for every 1 year of service.
So he worked 31 years, so he's getting 248 hours of sick time.
He never took sick time, so...
It's capped.
There's a cap. And he has 5 weeks vacation.
Or whatever he has left. But we need to budget for worst case.
That's why I was asking.
We have to budget for worst case scenario.
It is. The new personnel policy, there's a cap on how much vacation we can accumulate. Sick time, I believe we left it.
It was capped and it was remained the same.
That's another one of those things we're working on.
Okay, are we voting benefits?
Yeah.
Do we need to vote on that?
So the question, we kind of got to know if you guys recommend. I mean, we could just go through the warrant, and they're going to be in here as we go through.
Okay.
Make it quick.
We can make it quick. We talked about most of them.
A lot of them are just nonsense.
I think we've already recommended. What are those that we have not recommended?
I mean, 2, 3, 4 are generic borrowing ones.
Right.
You guys good with that?
Yeah.
Article 5 is to vote revolving funds.
Yeah.
Article 6, we have to vote revolving funds a different way. From this point forward, the Municipal Modernization Act, also known as Make Everybody Work More Act. We need to adopt bylaws, which establish the funds. And then, this is a one-time bylaw we adopt, establish the revolving funds. And then we just vote on the spending limits each year.
How big is the contractor?
Okay.
So in this year,
we have to vote on every year, then the spending limits every year.
Yeah, the spending limits.
So here it is on 7, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So
it's pretty much the exact same thing.
Let's just see how that goes.
But we need to vote it twice this year because also adopt the bylaw. There's legislation pending right now that would delay it till 19, so we don't know. We're going to do it both ways, just so we're covered.
Okay, so we need to vote that right now. Article 7?
If you want to recommend it.
Okay.
It says it's recommended.
Yeah, I think he put recommended.
Okay. I make a motion we recommend it.
Second?
There's no change on that. On what's been, right?
No.
Everything's...
All those in favor?
Aye.
Good. Article 8?
How do they decide how much to open a grave? How do they decide that?
I don't know.
You gotta pay for it back.
You gotta pay for it.
No, I know that, but every town, you can go to every town and every cemetery is different.
Ours is...
That's why I asked, how do you decide?
Depends if they're going face down or face up. Paul Florial.
All right, move on.
All right.
Nine. We do 8?
8.
Yeah, that's what the salary is.
2.5 COLA.
Yeah, all best.
Did we vote that? I don't think we did.
No.
Do I have a
I make a motion we approve Article 8.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Done. Article 9 is Enterprise Fund.
For the water.
Enterprise Fund. How are we doing on total expenses? What do they have, like 34 grand left in the budget?
I didn't get the retained earnings from reading. I thought they took it all in and spent it all out.
No, they have a...
They got a balance.
Retained earnings, they have... Let me see it here.
Total...
They have 64,000 in retained earnings. They have 64,000 in free cash right now.
Okay.
65,000.
All right.
That one you want to recommend it? I make a motion we recommend Article 9. Water Department?
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Good.
10.
10's a budget. Do we vote on a
So, shouldn't there be a number in here?
The whole budget will be lifted in there.
Okay. So the budget as we see it today with...
There'll be a few changes.
So...
What would be all these sheets that you gave us today?
Let's...
All the first two, maybe.
So budget 4A.
we'll vote it with a couple changes that you guys talked about. So this has the police reduced already.
And it has 4A.
Can I just say something about the schools? We badgered our departments to come in with level funded budgets, and I get the salaries and insurance are something we don't have any control over, but I think you have to start looking at the stuff behind the lines.
Bobby, you made a great point, and I think I'm not sure if you were there or not, but we need that. We're going to ask for that budget earlier, so
I can get the salaries and the insurance. I mean, I can't control that. I'm going to wait to tell you what about something else. You guys should know about. Bob especially should know.
I attended the Whately Elementary School meeting as well as the Frontier meeting, and in terms of how the process works, and I think this is a discussion we should have with the school committee. School committee are voted by the town, represent the town, they represent us. Yet I was at two meetings where the school committee voted to approve a budget that we hadn't even seen yet.
Hold on.
You don't have the floor. So what I want to do is have a discussion with them prior to their voting so that we can discuss the budget, school committee, and us before going forward. So that's something
I totally agree.
We could bring forward.
We didn't hold anything. Could I have the floor?
Are you asking? Yes.
Thank you. When did we vote the budget, Paul?
You voted the budget. I don't have the days.
But you voted it after the public hearing.
Right, but what I'm saying is...
We met with the Board of Selectmen and the Finance Committee, discussed our budget, answered your questions. You came to our public hearing. We answered your questions. The school committee agreed on a budget and voted it at that time. So don't say that we voted it before it even came to you guys, because that's a lie.
Okay, let me take that back. That's absolutely true. But the fact of the matter is that on the Frontier side...
I'm not talking Frontier. I'm not on the Frontier
budget. We got
budget.
The Frontier budget the night that we had the presentation by Frontier on their budget. So no one really had a chance to take a look at the budget.
I can't help you there. I'm on the Whately Elementary School Committee.
I know that. Okay, so I misspoke there, and I take that back. But the point I'm trying to make is that it would be very healthy if we could all sit down prior to your last meeting, where you guys have to tell them yay, nay, or... so that we can all get a sense of where it is, and you get a better sense of where the dollars are in town. That was my point.
But didn't the elementary and Frontier come in front of you guys back 2 months ago?
Yes.
And presented it, and then when we get the budget, Patty or somebody comes down here and hands the budgets to somebody in this office, so people can look at it, because at one time, years ago, it didn't work that way. You guys were upset. So as soon as we get them, we bring them right down and hand them to somebody here. I don't know who it is.
When we first got the budgets, did we approve them, act on them? I thought it was just for information, and we were going to act on the school budget when we saw the total budget. So by us receiving them, does that mean we approve them and they can go ahead with it?
But that's why we have a meeting. Right, we had a meeting then. We had a meeting with you guys.
You guys haven't done anything wrong. Okay, you haven't done anything wrong. What's wrong is how the timing that we've set up here, and we have to come up with a better timing for the process.
I mean, we get it in January. So between January and April 5th, I mean, we have dates, we have a timeline that we meet as a group, the subcommittees, we meet with the finance committee and the select board, then we have public comment, we have a public thing. I mean, we only meet once a month at Frontier and at Whately, so
But you say you get it in January. You get it from Patty in January?
We get it, then we bring it right over to you guys.
No, then that's fine. So that, you know, to drill down and start looking at these things, that we start crunching things.
Oh, I mean, absolutely.
For both budgets. And so we certainly don't want to be the ones that are going to tell you, like we went through tonight, how you're going to spend your money.
Right.
But there are some things that, you know, I know you're not buying a taser, but I'm sure there's something that's going to look like a taser in your budget that we're going to say, you know, this doesn't seem right, right? This doesn't seem right.
We might want one for our protection.
We're going to want to question something along
here. I just don't know when Patty could have the budget. Don't forget, she's doing five budgets. So it's like five budgets are different than one.
But that doesn't mean it's right. And like Paul says, it doesn't mean that you guys are doing anything wrong. No, and we're asking for something that's
no, I agree with you 100%. In fact, I was disappointed this year because we got our first round of the budget in January. Before, it always been December. Until we were already off by a month. Okay. But I understand where
you're at. I think going forward, that's important.
Okay, so Mary Ellen has to take this stuff down. So
sorry.
We need one conversation at a time. But I'm sorry I brought that up.
I just don't like hear you say that we voted something without even listening to you.
I misspoke on that. And what I meant was that, yes, we did see the budget, but it's the whole timing aspect of it that, in essence, even though sometimes we get the budget, there isn't enough time to pull it apart the way we would like to. And I think the way we need to. And if we work together, I think we can come up with a system that works for everybody a little better than what it does now. That's my only point. Sorry, guys. All right, who brought that up? I think that was Bob that brought that up. Okay.
All right,
you're open to.
So we're going to hold on the total budget for Article 10.
I'm not done yet. I got a good one for Bob.
Oh, I know.
So,
okay.
He's going to get up and leave.
No, he's not. He wants to hear
it. I'm here.
So 4A has police reduced.
Yeah.
Also, one other change that was made, because I figured it was easier to take it out than put it in. We need to, from budget 4A, here, highway department salaries.
We're going to reduce it.
It's going to be reduced by 2,000. It's going to be reduced by one. It's going to be reduced 128,864.
Yep.
Because there was a line for a new hire in there that.
Yep.
It's not recommended. So that's going to decrease that bottom figure here, total operating budget, by 2,000.
All right. So it's going to be $4,890,939.
Correct.
I make a motion we accept it.
Second. All those in favor of accepting $4,893,939 in the total operating budget?
Aye.
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 That's it.
All right. 11, 12, 13, 14. Let's do those in one shot.
Capital improvement plan?
Capital improvement stuff for the...
Let me just make sure those are that one.
Okay. Well, I'm going to take that money from free cash, 30,000, 7,500, 97,50, and 61,000. I make a motion we accept all those.
Accept articles 11, 12, 13, 14. All those in favor?
I'll second that.
All in
favor.
We also need to add in here, there was 5,000 to go to capital stabilization.
Yeah.
Right?
Yep.
And 10,000
for the cruiser.
10,000 for a police cruiser count, right? So those will be added in here as well. But you can approve the...
Those are more articles that aren't in here right now.
Right, those need to be added. But you will... So the Finance Committee approves, recommends that those...
Yes, I make a motion we approve those two articles.
Second.
Get that number. What number is that?
5,000 and 10,000.
The police cruiser count for 10 and highway department for 5?
Yep.
Okay, all those in favor?
Aye.
All right, 15 is 5,000 for a replacement of the water department truck. They're going to take it out of the enterprise fund. I make a motion we accept it.
Second?
Aye.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Second.
Third.
CPA. Okay. 16 is the appropriation. 17, 5,000 for Smith APR.
$21,000 to Whately Affordable Housing Trust, subject to grant agreement.
Okay.
We'll stop there and then we'll get into
it. Yep. All right. I make a motion. 16, 17, and 18.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye. Now, 19 is the town hall.
Okay. So I tried to group these together. So the next one, two, three, four will be town hall articles.
19, 20, 21, and 22.
Yes.
Which are all things we have discussed.
Yes, we have.
Okay, just so I know. 20 is we're going to do the borrowing, which will be paid back by the city.
If they need to borrow.
If they need to borrow, yeah. They don't get the grants. All right,
so
yep. I make a motion we accept 19, 20, 21, and 22.
Do I have a second?
I second.
All those in favor?
Aye. The 10,000 for the retired employee, we all know about that. I make a motion we accept Article 23.
Second.
Aye.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All right, what's 24?
Here's a curveball for you.
Yeah. Why are we donating money to the charities?
Yeah. So. Good question.
Yeah.
It is a real good
They've always given money to people in town.
Yeah. So they came before the select board,
mm-hmm.
and they discussed the need for is essentially a building feasibility study for their building. And they were asking participating the towns that are part of the Smith charities who they donate money to help pay for that study.
Why? They weren't asking very much either.
I believe they were asking for
$100.
Right? Any. I believe they said any amount.
What's the feasibility study? What are they going to do?
It's that building right on Main Street.
I know where it is. It's
a beautiful building.
It's a whole building. As long as it's not in excess of $100.
With parking.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, it's the selecting one of them.
What's the feasibility study about?
The building, I guess the building needs some work, some repair, and they were looking for anything.
How long do they use it? Good question.
Yeah, I don't know.
I don't know much about it. They're a secret society.
Anyway,
I make a motion we donate, we'll give them $100.
Second.
Yeah.
Give them the blue school.
Yeah, they get the blue school for their new office.
Free.
We'll
send them for $1.
For $1.
We'll pay our less to take that
school. Yeah, and the center school. We'll throw that one in too.
Okay. All right.
All those in favor of Article 24?
Aye.
$100.
25, we already know about. We're going to stick a good number, 200,000, or it may change.
Still holds.
Whatever.
Let's stick with the 200,000.
Good.
I make a motion we accept Article 25.
Second.
All those in favor?
Aye.
I will caution that we all know that reduces our tax levy, reduces our tax rate. It's one-time revenue, so we can't always depend on it.
Right.
But it's keeping our taxes down.
Right.
We may not have that money.
Next year, we might not have it. But
you never know.
Yeah.
Things happen. Okay. Go on. Come on, Tommy. You're on
even
a roll.
In lieu of taxes, for who's next, Amp? That's these birds in the back here?
The utility, they're solar.
Solar.
So what they requested from the this authorizes the select board to enter into a pilot agreement, which spaces out the personal property tax payments.
What are we doing with the other solar things we have in town?
Nothing.
We do have pilots on it, and I believe two kinds.
Use on site.
Yeah,
those are exempt.
Okay.
You got two kinds of solars, right? Was it private or pilot? How are they differentiated?
I think the ones that use electricity on site.
So essentially the payment has to be negotiated.
Yeah. Basically, we're just voting here to let the select board negotiate with.
Taxes for the rest of their lives.
I'll recommend it.
It's because the solar rates depreciate so quickly. There'd be huge payments up front.
That's two of them.
Yes. It helps them with their financing to spread it out over.
Okay, all those in favor of 26?
Aye.
Good.
I don't know if you want to take a position on the rest of them, but you're welcome to.
No.
No, they didn't vote on 27.
Yes, we did. 26 and 27, we voted on together.
Just so you know, those two will bring about 60 grand to the town a year, roughly, 50 to 60.
Nice.
There you go. If they get off the ground.
If they get permitted.
If they get permitted.
Oh my gosh, that's what the cell tower would be in between those two.
Five. Okay.
How do you come up with 60?
Or 50.
Big difference between 50 and 60.
24. No, 5,000, right? The lowest, maybe.
Yeah.
What's this other stuff on?
25,000. Those are my
Yeah, they don't affect us.
Corrosive influence of money on politics.
Yeah.
I'm all for it, everybody. Do we have term limits in here somewhere?
No.
I want term limits.
Well, I should have talked to you before I submitted it.
You want one on finance chair?
Yeah.
He might take
problem is nobody else wants to
job.
He might take you up on it.
It's been, I think, it's been empty for a while. How about a dental plan for the chair? Come on.
Yeah, there you go.
Are we good?
We're good.
Let me check.
Ryan, anything else before?
I think a motion we adjourn the meeting.
Okay, motion to adjourn.
I make a motion we adjourn.
All those in favor?
Aye.